Good evening, everybody. By way of introduction, my name is Anil Dutt. I'm a partner in Lakshmi Kumar and Sridharan, and I handle IP litigation. I would like to give you insight with regard to the first ever litigation of Ericsson. As we know, Ericsson is one of the primary owner with regard to advanced technology on telecommunication. From 2007 until 2018, India had a dual protection mechanism whereby a SAP holder or a patent holder could protect the validity or the infringement of its patent either through the custom routes or through the civil court. With regard to the civil court, the relief which could be sought by a patent holder could be very wide, wherein they could say that these are my patents, the defendant is infringing them, so therefore they can seek a prayer that the defendant should not infringe any of those patent, any of the suit patent while coming out with their new product. Whereas with regard to custom enforcement, the relief is very specific. In custom enforcement, what the patent holder needs to do is they need to do a survey, figure out from the market which all are the models which are infringing the suit patent, and submit those models with the customs after getting themselves registered with the custom authorities. So with regard to Ericsson, the time period late 2000, while Ericsson was negotiating its FRAND terms with different Indian mobile manufacturer, which is a prerequisite requirement being a SAP holder, Ericsson was simultaneously also conducting market survey. And during that market survey, Ericsson found out that there were certain samples of mobile phones which were infringing its technology, but they were not able to figure out as to who the manufacturer were because the manufacturing was done from China and the goods were being imported into India. So the best recourse available to Ericsson at that point in time was to request the customs under the IPR custom enforcement rule, as we call them, of 2007, to file a request with the custom authority stating that as and when these models are being imported, kindly interdict them, don't release them, because they're infringing our patent technology. On one hand, Ericsson did so, and on the other hand, with regard to the other Indian manufacturer, Ericsson was negotiating its FRAND terms. 2012 was the year when a consignment was being sought to be imported by KingTech Indian Company, and that was the time when the custom authorities interdicted that consignment. On interdiction, the Indian company approached the Delhi High Court, wherein the main argument was that the interdiction by the customs was unauthorized, the custom don't have the rule. The primary act which plays on this is the Patent Act and not the custom. At that point in time, the single judge agreed with them and a direction was being issued to the custom authorities to immediately release the goods. However, as per the request of the Ericsson, that order was being suspended for 10 days time period so that Ericsson could appeal against that order before a division bench, which is a two-judge bench. On appeal, the division bench stayed the order of the single judge and said that while we look into this issue, the proper recourse for Ericsson would be to initiate a civil action because ultimately it has to be a civil action through which Ericsson can enforce its rights. When the civil, and that is how the first ever litigation was being filed by Ericsson with regard to its 5 patent, which pertains to the AMR technology, which is adaptive multi-rate, which deals with the clarity of the speech. So that was the time when the first suit was being filed by Ericsson before the single judge of the Delhi High Court. And the Delhi High Court, what the court held was that till the time the goods, because Ericsson had already furnished the requisite information to the custom authorities that these particular models were infringing. So the court held that this prima facie view, that prima facie evidence has already been given. But still what we will do is we'll pick out the samples from the consignment and send it to an independent testing laboratory to see as to whether what Ericsson is saying is correct or not. And until that time, the consignment will not be released. Now coming back to the division bench, because by that time the matter was also ripe for hearing before the division bench, the important thing was there was no challenge to the rules. It was only with regard to the interpretation of the rules. So the division bench held that so far as the rules are concerned, that gives ample power to the custom authorities to interdict the consignment. However, cases wherein the custom authorities would feel that the technology is very complex, in those cases, the authority may relegate the parties to civil court to obtain a stay order from the civil court within a specific time period. This particular finding was taken up in appeal in Supreme Court. However, the Supreme Court did not interfere with it. So what remained was that yes, under the IPR rules 2007, the custom authorities had the power to interdict consignment depending upon the specific models which the right holder would submit before the custom authorities. However, during the course of the proceeding, if the officer deems it proper that this is a technology which is far beyond me, you know, I will not be able to adjudicate on it, he can relegate the parties to civil court. Now coming back to the civil court wherein Ericsson initiated its first suit, after testing it was found that out of the 10 models, 7 were infringing the Ericsson 5 patents. And the single judge also observed that we were ready to enter into an agreement with this Chinese entity, KingTech, so as to enter into an agreement whereby they would pay us royalty and we would agree on those front terms. It so happened that when the court was about to pronounce an order after hearing the parties that yes, these goods cannot be imported and these goods are infringing and you have not complied in entering into negotiable agreement with Ericsson, that was the time when KingTech gave an undertaking that don't pass an order against me, I undertake not to import any such goods in the near future. So that was the time when no injunction was being passed, but because of the undertaking, the suit got disposed of. So therefore, what is very essential is with regard to SAPs, especially and in terms of the front obligation, it is very important that a bargaining power is required to be given with regard to the manufacturer who are incorporating the technology in their handset, because what happens is they don't have any alternate. Unlike other patent wherein they can take alternate technology, they can incorporate alternate technology, with regard to SAP, they have to necessarily employ that. And therefore, it should not be a case wherein the court comes to a finding that this was abuse of their dominant position. So therefore, this negotiation aspect is really, really important. And that set the ball rolling for Ericsson, because in all subsequent proceedings, whether with regard to Micromax or Intex or Lava or any other case, as a matter of fact, it was on these two finding of the division bench of the Delhi High Court wherein they said custom had the power, and also with regard to the order of the single judge with regard to KingTech, that Ericsson obtained interim injunction with regard to all manufacturers who were incorporating the technology of Ericsson. With regard to the royalty to be paid, that was actually never an issue which was being gone into in detail by the civil court in India. What was being held was, in most of the cases, as of now, there is only an interim injunction being passed, and most of the cases, the final adjudication is yet to take place, the trial is yet to commence. But in the interregnum, the court had held that the royalty which will be charged from Ericsson will be based on the selling price and not on the price with regard to the particular technology which will be embedded in a particular chip or so. There could be many technologies, but ultimately, you'll have to see the function of the phone. So therefore, the High Court at least have agreed that the royalty which is required to be paid by the manufacturer who are incorporating the technology of the patent holder, they have to pay the royalty as per the percentage of the selling price. And of course, pursuant thereto, Micromax and Intex, they filed a complaint with the Competition Commission also that so far as Ericsson is concerned, being the SAP holder, they are abusing their dominant position. And that was in those cases, the CCI, what they have done is they have prima facie formed an opinion and they have appointed a DG, which is the Director General, to investigate into the allegation made by these Indian manufacturers. Now, the appointment of the DG was again challenged by Ericsson before the Delhi High Court. And the Delhi High Court in 2016, by the detailed order, have come to a finding that CCI and the civil court, they work in two different spheres. While the CCI will look into as to whether Ericsson or a patent holder have abused their dominant position and whether they are an enterprise, they do possess a dominant position with regard to that particular sector of the market. So far as the civil court is concerned, that will ensure that the patent granted to the right holder is not infringed. So therefore, both of them work in two different spheres. We are yet to see as to whether what ultimate finding the CCI is going to give. We are yet to see as to what the civil courts are going to hold with regard to the royalty which is being currently charged, which is on the sale price. But to obtain a stay order or to obtain an interim order from the court, it is very, very important to ensure that there are negotiations between the right holder and the manufacturer so that tomorrow the manufacturer cannot say that I was given no opportunity. Like I said earlier, the manufacturer has no choice but to incorporate that technology. So therefore, adequate opportunity is to be given to the right holder so that, and in case only if it is an unwilling licensee, that will be the case when the High Court or any other court will grant an interim injunction. Because in India, as you would know, damage is the adequate remedy. because the court may not grant an injunction because where they say that yes, the damages can be computed in terms of money, and at a post-trial stage, if it is found that yes, the defendants were infringing your essential patents and all, by payment of money, we can calculate the amount, they will reimburse you. But by that time, with regard to their other worldwide rights and other worldwide litigation, so therefore, it is essential that proper negotiations take place with regard to SCP patents in terms of front. Thank you so much.